Hello, my name is Christopher Shuman. I am a University of Maryland glaciologist based at NASA Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, and I study changes to Earth's cryosphere for NASA. In the next few minutes, I'd like to take you to East Greenland and through time to show you one of this ice sheet's three largest outlet glaciers. Using satellite imagery, you will see Helheim Glacier undergoing obvious changes through the past nearly 50 years. In the first frame of this talk, the small blue rectangle just below the Arctic Circle shows the study's focus area and will be shown in subsequent frames using Landsat satellite imagery. This area is about 24.3 by 43 kilometers or 15 by 27 miles in extent. To give you a sense of its size, this area would nearly cover the cities of San Francisco and Oakland, California, as well as the bay between them. Our first clear view of the Helheim area was acquired in early September 1972 by the Landsat 1 Multispectral Scanner, or MSS. It shows the bright white ice and snow of the Greenland ice sheet's margin at the left side of the frame, and the darker, rougher, faster-flowing rivers of ice that join together near the center of the frame to form Helheim Glacier. This glacier is approximately 6.3 or 3.9 miles wide as it flows into its deep fjord. At its front, glacial ice calves off into the ocean waters to form many different sized icebergs. Smaller glaciers and ice caps can also be seen against the area's brownish bedrock, and have some bright white snow cover as well. This and all subsequent images are presented in natural color to simulate what a human would see if they were flying high above the area. The first available Landsat 5 thematic mapper, or TM, coverage over this area is a composite of two scenes acquired about a week apart in August 1985. The increased resolution of the TM imagery compared to the original MSS view makes surface crevasses, or deep cracks, on the faster-flowing glacial ice more apparent, as well as a number of small bright blue meltwater ponds on the glacier's surface. Some ice front advance down the fjord can also be seen relative to the 1972 image. In addition, a tabular or flat-topped iceberg more than a kilometer long, 3,300 feet, has recently calved from the glacier's ice front. Additional ice front retreat since 1985 is visible in a single Landsat 5 TM image in early September 1992. Variations in ice albedo, or the brightness of the snow and ice surface in these frames, is due to changes in the late summer snow cover from year to year. Due to melting and other processes, snow-free glacial ice appears darker than nearby bright white snow-covered ice. Snow on bedrock areas suggests a recent snowstorm has occurred. 6 years later, an early September 1998 Landsat 5 TM image shows Helheim's ice front seems to have varied only slightly in position relative to 1992. However, the snow-covered area in the frame is greatly reduced, and all the tributary glaciers show much more dark, low albedo glacial ice. This indicates widespread surface melting has occurred during this summer's melt season. In early August 2002, a Landsat 7 Enhanced Thematic Mapper Plus, or ETM Plus, scene shows several kilometers of ice front retreat in the fjord relative to nearly the same time of year in 1998. Snow cover in the area is fairly extensive at the time this image was acquired. However, the bright blue glacial melt ponds that were visible in previous years are no longer evident. This Landsat 7 ETM Plus shows additional ice front retreat has occurred by mid-August 2007. This frame also shows that a problem has impacted the ETM Plus sensor on orbit, causing gaps and colored lines to appear in the image shown here. In late May 2003, the scanline corrector on ETM Plus failed, causing incomplete coverage to all subsequent Landsat 7 scenes. Fortunately, a second ETM Plus image from slightly earlier in August, with offsetting gaps, allows the frame to be filled in almost completely. Similarly to the 2007 frame, a mid-August 2011 ETM Plus image shows colored lines and filled gaps. It also shows several kilometers of ice front advance. Further, two large tabular icebergs can be seen floating in the fjord from a recent calving event. Changes to the inland portion of the glacier system can lead to additional ice advance or retreat in the fjord. But widespread areas of darker ice and little bright white snow cover in this frame again suggests extensive surface melting in this late summer time frame. A Landsat 8 operational land imager, or OLI, image over the Helheim area shows slight ice front retreat has occurred since the previous 2011 frame. Further, low albedo, darker ice areas are again widespread, and snow is almost entirely absent on both bedrock and glacial ice areas. The small ice caps just to the south of Helheim are very dark and appear to have shrunk quite a bit in recent years. This Landsat 8 OLI image from mid-August 2016 shows that low albedo, darker ice is again extensive, and snowmelt conditions appear to be continuing broadly across the whole area. Although there is little glacier front retreat compared to 2014, a small circular ice front Pollenia, or opening in the floating iceberg debris, in the fjord is evident. Pollenias like this are due to rising glacial meltwater that is draining from the glacier system further inland. This current of fresher water pushes iceberg debris away in the area where it upwells. A mid-August 2019 Landsat 8 OLI image shows additional low albedo conditions across the Helheim area, and also several kilometers of ice front retreat since 2016. Further, a much larger Pollenia has formed in front of the glacier during an exceptionally strong melt event that impacted most of Greenland in the summer of 2019. As measured on this satellite image, the open water area is about 600 meters, 1,970 feet in length. Further, the available satellite imagery indicates that the Pollenia was visible close to the ice front from early July to the middle of August in 2019. Three days after Landsat 8 collected the previous image over the Helheim area, NASA's Oceans Melting Greenland, OMG, project flew over that open patch of water in a long-range research aircraft and took a series of spectacular pictures detailing Helheim's calving ice front. The OMG team also dropped a temperature-measuring probe into the Pollenia. This probe detected warm water well above freezing, all the way to the bottom of the fjord, at about 766 meters, more than 2,500 feet below sea level. The OMG project has been examining how ocean waters melt Greenland's glaciers from below, even as air temperatures warm the ice from above. Four days after the OMG flight, a Landsat 8 OLI image showed that extensive calving from the glacier had moved the ice front about 300 meters 985 feet further inland, and smothered the upwelling fresher water of the Pollenia in floating glacial ice debris. This image also shows the positions of every previous ice front in this time series to provide a sense of the net retreat of this major Greenland outlet glacier. In this last frame, a mid-August 2020 Landsat 8 OLI image shows that the ice front has advanced about 1 kilometer, 3,300 feet, compared to 2019. However, later Landsat images showed that most of this glacial advance calved away by early September and again covered the ice front Pollenia. Comparing imagery from the past 2 years, it appears that the summer of 2020's surface melt in East Greenland was not as severe as in 2019. Even so, the ice front Pollenia formed again, although it was reduced in area and duration. The recurrence of the Pollenia in recent years suggests that more meltwater may be available within Helheim's flow system. And, more obviously, bedrock exposures between the tributary glaciers in this area have become much more extensive since 1972. This indicates that the area's glacial ice cover is thinning as well as retreating during the Landsat era. In summary, Helheim Glacier, one of the largest and fastest flowing glaciers in Greenland, has retreated approximately 7.5 kilometers, almost 4.7 miles, up a wide fjord over the last nearly 50 years, leaving a melange of icebergs where the glacier's calving front used to be. And in closing, I'll mention that the joint NASA-USGS Landsat program is scheduled to launch Landsat 9 in September 2021, and will also celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Landsat program on July 23rd, 2022. Thank you very much for your interest and time.